Hello and welcome. Thanks for tuning in. It's nice to have you with us for the second part of our big liquid wax comparison and especially the conclusion of all the testing I did. Now, this was one of the most interesting but also most intense testing I did in a long time. To be perfectly honest with you, before I started with this video and this test, I did not have that much experience with the category of liquid waxes. I didn't really saw their point, as I didn't really understood why someone would go for such a product compared to a nice paste wax. However, after all the testing I did, I think I now understand why these products can be an attractive option, especially because they are so incredibly easy to use. Now, normally I would now go ahead and present to you a summary of what I found about each and every one of those products, and then I would let you decide which product to go for based on your personal preferences. However, I see and I understand why so many of you like when we as YouTubers present you point systems and rankings, as they can help you in making an educated buying decision. And so even if I personally don't like those point systems, because they are highly subjective and I as a tester can always adapt and tweak the point system so that the product that I want to win actually wins at the end, but I did my best to come up with an objective and fair system which I will now present to you. The product characteristics I recognized were the price per liter of these products, the scent, the application, the removal, the felt slickness that they created, the color enrichment, as well as the masking effect, the hydrophobics as a whole and the beading especially, as well as the chemical and mechanical resistance. Now, it wouldn't make much sense to weight those categories of product characteristics all in the same way. As for example, the scent and slickness that these products create can be an important factor for some of you, but I think for most people out there, they don't really care how a product smells and they also don't touch their cars all the time, which is why I weighted these two categories, the scent and the slickness, with 0.25. I also weighted the application and the removal both with 0.5, because yes, I think it's an important aspect of those products. However, I don't want to punish any of those products if they are a tiny little bit harder to apply, but then show a significantly better performance because of this. The price per liter, the hydrophobics as well as the beadings are weighted by 1.5, because I actually think those characteristics of the products are a bit more important for most of you out there, and because I also know that so many of you want resistant and want very durable products, I weighted the category of the resistance I tested with 2. The color enrichment as well as the masking effect I weighted with 1, because I think especially with liquid waxes, yes, I think they are important factors, but probably not as important as the other ones. So you now know the categories by which I rated these products. You know the weighting of those categories, and now you need to know how I gave those products points. And this is a simple one. I gave them points in each and every one of those categories between 0 and 10. 0 meaning bad, 10 meaning very, very good. Now, if you are good with maths, you already realize that there are 10 categories. The products can get a maximum of 10 points. And if you sum up the weightings I just told you, then you realize that the maximum of points that those products could get is 100. And this was a deliberate choice because I think that based on such a simple number, it is much easier for you to arrange the results of the testing I will present to you now. One last important note before we start with the actual ranking. Some of you will already have realized that there are products within this test that aren't really liquid waxes. And on the one hand, we have traditional paint sealants, which were included in this test, as well as all-in-one polishes, meaning products which are supposed to polish, fill, as well as protect your paint. And in the ranking I will present to you now, I will arrange the products from those two categories. However, they will not be considered in the final ranking because the final ranking will consist only of liquid waxes in order to be consistent with this test as well as the title of this video. So I would say let's now start with the ranking of the best liquid waxes according to me. Unfortunately, there has to be a last place and therefore the worst product out of this comparison, which is not a liquid wax despite what the manufacturer writes on the bottle, And this is the Tonyin liquid wax. If you look at the point score of the Tonyin wax, you will realize that the price of this is not the issue, as it is actually rather fairly priced. I think the main issue lies in its name, because Tonyin says it is a liquid wax. However, in the product description on their own bottle, they already say in the first sentence, this polish. And this, I think, is the secret to understand this product. This is not a liquid wax. This is a traditional all-in-one type polish, which is supposed to remove or fill light paint defects and leave some basic form of protection behind. However, we clearly saw in the hydrophobics, the beading, and the resistancy that the protection that this product is supposed to leave behind is not really there. Yes, it was able to remove, or I much more think that it filled light paint defects on our test panel rather well, but every finishing polish is better at this, and we actually had two other all-in-one type products in this comparison which were as good or better at this, but also clearly left something behind on the paint that worked. And so at the end of the day, this is not only a bad liquid wax, it is also a bad all-in-one type product. And this explains why it only scored 39.5 points and reached the last place in this comparison. With 39.75 points, so only 0.25 points better than the Tonyin, was the InnovaCard G1 Glossy, which is the second worst product in this comparison, and it ranks on place 17 in the liquid wax comparison. Now, in all fairness, InnovaCard talks with the G1 Glossy about a product that is supposed to be fast to apply, offers a silk effect and extra gloss. And at the end of the day, yes, this product delivers on all those promises. It has a pronounced darkening effect, it is comparably good at filling up light paint defects, and it does create a rather slick surface. So I think this is not a case of a manufacturer over-promising and under-delivering, but based on the fact that this is not actually a cheap product, I just think that we saw products in this comparison which are able to do the exact same things finish-wise to your paint, but then offer so much more. Because next to its finish capabilities, this product doesn't offer anything in terms of hydrophobics, resistancy, or beading. And if you look at the point system, that's the reason why it only scored 39.75 points and reached the last place in our liquid wax comparison. Place 16 in the liquid wax comparison scored 41.25 points and therefore was only slightly better than the first two products I presented to you, and this is the Liquid Elements Shield Wax. When you look at the points table for the Liquid Elements Shield Wax, I think you already see what the issue is. It's not that this product is bad in all the aspects, because it is rather hydrophobic and it is rather durable. However, its major flaw is its incredible high price point. At 15 euros for 100 milliliters, this product has a liter price of 150 euros. And these are prices that we normally just see with luxury brands like Polish Angel, Swiss Wax, or Zymol. And you really have to ask yourself, what the hell was Liquid Elements thinking that they can suddenly compete with such luxury brands? The product is called Shield Wax, and I think the name hints to the underlying issue of this product. According to Liquid Elements, this does contain real ceramic content, as it is found, for example, in the ceramic coating that Liquid Elements offers. And so, of course, this product will be difficult to apply if there are real ceramic components in there. However, Liquid Elements also says that this is supposed to be a show wax. And so the question really arises, why do there have to be ceramic components in a show wax? Because show waxes are supposed to be quick and easy to apply and do something for the finish of your car. And in this respect, there don't have to be ceramic components in this. If the high price and if the difficult application would result in an extremely durable or extremely hydrophobic product, then maybe this would have done better. But because the hydrophobics and the resistancy were only average, and if you combine this with the extremely high price and the difficult application, then the results are only 41.5 points and the second to last place in our liquid wax comparison. Now, the next product scored 47.25 points, so was significantly better than the first three. However, regarding the big name of the brand behind this product, I think that place 15 in the liquid wax comparison is a slight disappointment. I'm talking about the Auto Finesse Radiance. It's not that I don't like Auto Finesse. I actually think they have one of the single most beautiful and unique product designs on the market, and those products really look fantastic on the shelf. This one also smells fantastic. Yeah, and is incredibly easy to apply, really does something for your finish in terms of a darkening effect, of a masking effect. It creates a very slick surface and is incredibly easy to use. However, in today's competitive market, this is not enough. Because you can have all that by so many other brands and so many other products, which offer exactly the same in terms of the finishing capabilities, but so much more in terms of hydrophobics and especially regarding the resistance, because that was one of the major weak points of this product. So at the end of the day, I just have to say that for what it is, this product simply is too expensive, and this is why it only scored 47.25 points and reached place 15 in our liquid wax comparison. Place 14 amongst the liquid waxes scored 49.5 points and therefore is only a tiny little bit below the 50 points mark, but I have to say it is one of the most disappointing products in my view, because I expected so much more from such a well-known brand in Germany and regarding its price point, and that is the Surfaces Hybrid Wax Cream. I already said it before when I compared the price levels of those products. Yes, you can buy a whole liter of this product and then it becomes significantly cheaper, but a liter of liquid wax is a shitload of product. And if all the other products are available in much smaller sizes, then I don't think it's fair that I consider such a huge amount of wax. And let's face it, this small bottle of wax with 250 milliliters costs 19 euros, which makes it an incredibly expensive product. But I think the real issue is that when it comes to its hydrophobics and its resistance, it just isn't up there with all the other waxes we just saw. And this becomes especially bad if a manufacturer claims that it should come with extremely good hydrophobics, which is written on the bottle here. And based on the results that we saw with the resistance tests, I also highly doubt that this product will reach a durability of 6 to 12 months, which Surfaces is promising here. And this is an issue we see so many times in car care, manufacturers overpromising and underdelivering. And based on the extremely high price of this product, the fact that it doesn't come with a nice scent, although the smell of those products is weighted extremely low and almost does nothing to the results, this product only scored 49.5 points and reached place 14 in the liquid wax comparison. On a side note, if I would have considered the price that you pay if you buy a whole liter of this, this would only have meant that this product would have scored two places higher in the list, so also not significantly better. With place 13 and 53.75 points, the next product may look like a disappointment, but I actually think it fared rather well, and this is the Meguiar's Deep Crystal Carnauba Wax. If you look at the points table, then you already see that this product has a lot of strengths and only some weaknesses. If this product would be more hydrophobic and more resistant, then this would be a fantastic product because it is one of the easiest, if not the easiest to apply. It does create a very nice finish to your car based on the darkening, the color enrichment, and the masking effect that it offers. It is definitely one of the slickest products you can use, and it does all that while still be very, very easy to use. And this is why this product gets a special price within our list, which is that this definitely is one of our tips for you if you are a beginner. This is a fantastic choice for all of you beginners out there, because it is foolproof, because it creates very nice results. And the only thing that you have to live with is that it is not as durable and not as hydrophobic as some others out there. Because of all that, and because it is very fairly priced, it reached 53.75 points, as well as place 13. And as bad as this sounds, if you consider that this one left behind Auto Finesse Surfaces and liquid elements, I actually think that this is a very respectable result. Place 12 amongst the liquid waxes already left some big name brands behind it, scored 57.75 points, and here's to the name Wax Planet Duragloss. To be absolutely clear about it, this is not the most hydrophobic and not the most durable product. It is exceptionally easy to use, it does a lot for the finish of your car, and it does all that whilst being the cheapest product out of this comparison by a long mile. I think its main issue is that the other two products by Wax Planet were much, much better in terms of the performance when it comes to hydrophobics and resistancy, whilst not being that much worse in the application as well as the finish capabilities. And let's not forget that this one scored much, much better than many other products which we had in this comparison. And so place 12 with 57.75 points is a very respectable result for a product which at the end of the day, I personally think is actually more like a glaze than a traditional liquid wax. So maybe I will have a look at this in a later glaze comparison, but for now I think you now know what to expect from the Duragloss. With 58 points, the next product reached place 11 in the liquid wax comparison, but has one major flaw, and this is Polish Angels Snow White. Now, the Polish Angel Snow White is not a bad product by any means, because as you can see in the points table, especially regarding the removal as well as the slickness that it creates, it really is class leading. And it also did rather well in the hydrophobics and resistance department. However, for the extremely high and ridiculous price that Polish Angel asks for this product, it really should have scored 10 points in every category there is, because only then the manufacturer could justify that a product has to cost that much money, because then we could say it just is very difficult to produce a product which is extremely easy to apply, does create an extremely nice effect to the finish of your car, and is extremely durable and hydrophobic. But as long as it is not capable of doing this, I have to say this product is way too expensive for what it offers. Even if I would have used the version for dark color paints and it would have scored 10 points in that category, and it would have scored 10 points in the color enrichment category, then it still would only have jumped 2 or 3 places in the final ranking. And regarding all of this, I just have to say this product is way too expensive for what it offers, for what it can do, and never really stood a chance. Because in all fairness, such extremely expensive products probably will never win such comparisons if they consider prices or a value for money component. And those are the reasons why the Polish Angel Snow White only scored 58 points and reached a shared 11th place. The next product also reached 58 points and therefore shares place 11 together with the Polish Angel Snow White, and this is the Tenzi Ceramic Wax. In a lot of ways, the Tenzi Ceramic Wax was a positive surprise, because it fared rather well in each and every of the performance categories. However, it wasn't top in any of those categories. And so at the end of the day, if you consider the comparably high price of approximately 50 euros per liter, the performance that it actually showed just wasn't quite enough. And from this perspective, the product is rather disappointing, because it comes from Poland, and if it would be offered on the same price level as stuff from RRC, from Shiny Garage, or from ADBL, then it would already have ranked much higher in the list. And if the manufacturer would be able to tweak the product to have slightly better resistance and slightly better hydrophobics for a slightly lower price, then this actually would have the potential to be a front runner. But as it is, it only reached 58 points and a shared 11th place together with the Polish Angel. The next product is not actually a liquid wax, but an all-in-one polish instead. And considering this, it fared extremely well in this comparison. It reached 58.5 points. And I'm talking about the Turtle Wax Ceramic Polish and Wax. There will be some amongst you that look at the results for the Turtle Wax Hybrid Solution Ceramic Polish and Wax and will think that it is disappointing. However, let's not forget that this is not a liquid wax, but a traditional all-in-one product, meaning that this is supposed to polish, fill, and protect your paint in just one step and one product. And in this regard, I actually think that the result that the Turtle Wax reached is extremely good, because to be absolutely clear about it, this one one was by far the best product at masking or even removing light paint defects within the whole field of products we tested. And despite this amazing ability, it actually created a more hydrophobic and more durable surface than some of the dedicated liquid waxes that we saw. And if we consider all of that, then I actually think that the 58.5 points that this product reached are very respectable, and that if this comparison would have been an all-in-one polish comparison, that it would have been a front runner. The next product reached a tiny bit more than 59 points and placed 10 in the liquid wax comparison. However, I think that most of you thought that it would fare much better based on the reputation that it has garnered amongst English-speaking car care YouTube channels, and this is the Collinite 845. I think the term that summarizes the performance of the Collinite 845 the best is because yes, it does a tiny little bit for the finish of your car. Yes, it does have some basic masking abilities. And yes, it is a rather hydrophobic and rather durable product. But if we are honest, that's about it. And in all those aspects, it's exactly the same story as with the Collinite 476S. It's a good wax, it's a solid wax, it's a rather hydrophobic and rather durable wax, but that's really it. There just are products out there in today's market which offer more in terms of hydrophobics, more in terms of durability, smell better, are presented in a nicer way, contain more modern ingredients, and just all in all offer you more, especially if you consider the price. Yes, I know this one is far cheaper in the US than it is in Central Europe, but compared to all the other products and considering what I had to pay to get this, I just don't think that this is an outstanding product. And based on all of this, I was rather disappointed by this product because there are so many rave reviews, especially in the US, about this product. And I think what happened here is that a lot of those guys used this product for years, which is fine, which is okay, because it is a solid product. But you have to accept that the world has moved on, that there are more brands in today's market, and just because you don't know those brands and you don't know the offerings by those brands, you cannot and you shouldn't go ahead as a car care YouTuber and declare this one the best liquid wax, because it just simply isn't, especially because this is not the easiest product by any means. And to be absolutely clear about it, it just barely was better than an all-in-one polish and wax product, and this already tells you everything you have to know about this product. So based on all of this, it reached 58.75 points and only placed 10 in our liquid wax comparison, which was disappointing for me. It probably is also disappointing for you because we both had higher expectations for this one, but that's just the reality of testing. Now it gets very, very close because the places 9 to 4 are only separated by 4 points. And the next product, which reached place 9 in the liquid wax comparison, surprised me from the very first application outside of this test, and this is the Dunkin' Biscuit Quartz. Now every year there are popping up so many different tiny brands on the detailing market that you and I ask ourselves, are they really bringing something new to the market? And to be honest, most of the times these offerings are disappointing because at best they offer average products, most likely rebottled ones, for comparably high prices because they cannot pump out enough products to offer them at lower prices. With Dunkin' Biscuit and based on my experience with their products, it is a tiny bit different because every single one I tried so far, for example, the shampoo, the foam, and also the quick detailer, they work, I would say, above average and really offer solid product performance for fair prices. And it's exactly the same story with their quartz hybrid wax sealant. It is reasonably easy to use, it does something for the finish of your car, and it's also rather hydrophobic and rather durable. And if it would be a tiny little bit cheaper and would be a tiny little bit better at masking light paint defects, because the products in the places from 9 to 4 are so close together in regards to their points that they reach, this product could easily jump up a few places. And so I actually think that place 9 and the 61.5 points it reached are very, very respectable. As I said, the products which we are talking about right now are very, very, very close in regards to the points that they reached. And so the next one, place 8 in the liquid wax comparison, scored 62.5 points. So only 0.5 points more than the last one. But I actually think it's a very, very good one. It's the Autoglanz Luminosity. The Autoglanz Luminosity was one of the most surprising products, and in a positive way. I think the reason that it surprised me so much is that by the look of it, this is a rather unspectacular product. It comes in a box standard bottle. The skin-like color of the product is not very attractive. The label looks a bit unspectacular, and in fact, the whole product does not look very inviting. However, this already changes if you open the bottle or use the product and smell the, I think it is a tutti frutti scent. And also regarding all the other aspects of it, application, finish, hydrophobic performance, durability, this one really can compete with what, for example, Meguiar's offers you for a much, much higher price. Because this one costs almost half of what Meguiar's charges you for the hybrid ceramic liquid wax. And this is when we talk about standard prices, because with Autoglanz, every few months they do a sale. And if you get this product for an even cheaper price, then if we look at the points that it got, it would jump even higher in the list of liquid waxes. So at the end of the day, the 62 points and place 8 that this product achieved is already very respectable. However, if you look at how close it came to a product offered by such a big name manufacturer that is Meguiar's, then once again, this is a very, very positive surprise. The next product reached place 7 in the liquid wax comparison and 63 points. But once again, I think that most of you thought it would fare much better. And this is the Meguiar's hybrid ceramic liquid wax. On the surface of it, you could say that 63 points and place 7 in this comparison is a good result for the hybrid ceramic liquid wax by Meguiar's. And indeed, its main strengths are the easy application, the nice smell, the fantastic presentation, and that it is rather and comparably hydrophobic. However, in regards to the chemical and mechanical resistance, there are already some issues there, but its main weakness is its incredibly high price everywhere on the world outside the US. I mean, yes, I believe that this is probably the best wax that Meguiar's currently offers, and this includes their paste waxes, and that the combination of the liquid wax and the ceramic detailer, the green bottle, will not be a disappointing combination of products. However, I already think that the hybrid ceramic spray wax is all in all the better product, because it does even more for the finish of your car, and it is even more hydrophobic. And most importantly, I also think it's more resistant and more durable. If you don't apply this, like Meguiar says, onto a wet car, but a dry car instead. And more importantly, I actually think that it is a shame for such a huge company that Meguiar's is, and that can invest so much money into R&D, that waxes by much, much smaller companies, some of them are run by just one person, did a lot better in this comparison. Place 6 amongst the liquid waxes reached 63.5 points, was a huge surprise, but that's the beauty of such comparison tests, that products by small, local and unknown manufacturers also get a chance to shine. And this is what happened with the Wax Planet Maracana. The Wax Planet Maracana is a perfect example of how delicate such point systems and rankings are. Because yes, it reached 63.5 points and therefore placed 6 in our liquid wax ranking. However, from a purely objective performance standpoint, it is not capable to hold up with the Meguiar's hybrid ceramic liquid wax or the Autoglanz Luminosity. The reason it overtook these two products is that it has an incredibly strong and pleasant banana scent. However, as a reminder, the scent has only a very tiny weight in the overall ranking and point system. More importantly, this is incredibly easy to apply, even more so than the other two products, and it also grabs points in every single one of the performance categories. Or in other words, it doesn't lose any points in any of those categories. Plus, regarding its price point, it comes in at pretty much half the price of the Meguiar's hybrid ceramic liquid wax, and these are the reasons
why this one scored so good. However, what's even more important for me is that compared to Tony Maguire's Deep Crystal Carnauba Wax, which was our tip for beginners, you could say that this is even the better alternative because it is as easy to apply, does create pretty much the same results, but is a tiny bit more resistant and a tiny bit more hydrophobic. And this is why this product also is our tip for you beginners out there.
The next product reached 64 points, but is technically not a liquid wax, and this is the Maguire's M27.
Technically, the Maguire's M27 is a paint sealant, which is why it didn't make it into the final ranking and list of the liquid waxes. Talking about those ingredients, strictly speaking, this is some sort of a ceramic paint sealant that sits happily in between traditional polymer paint sealants and ceramic coatings, but is not quite the same stuff and is not quite on the same level as something like, for example, the Fireball Ultimate Nano Coat. So you could say this is a ceramic paint sealant or a paint sealant plus, as I would much rather call it. More importantly, regarding pretty much all of the performance categories, this performed a tiny little bit better than the Hybrid Ceramic Liquid Wax by Maguire's, which is why, in my personal opinion, this is the product that the Maguire's Hybrid Ceramic Liquid Wax should have been, because this really can keep up with the top stuff in this category. But once again, the main issue of this product is its high price everywhere outside the US. I know you can get it cheaper in the US, but I am living in Central Europe and there it is a rather expensive product, and this is pretty much the only reason why it didn't rank higher in our rank. There's one additional issue I have with this product. Being a ceramic paint sealant, I actually think that it should not have only done a tiny bit better than the Hybrid Ceramic Liquid Wax. It should have performed much, much better in terms of the hydrophobics and also in terms of the resistance. But on the other hand, and I'm talking to you right now, Liquid Elements, this product is what the Shield Wax should and could have been, meaning it's very easy to apply. It's pretty much exactly as resistant and as durable. So it is possible to create such a product.
The next product reached 65 points, is not a liquid wax neither, but it's one of the biggest surprises of this whole comparison, because I never thought that an all-in-one polish would fare so good. I'm talking about the Auto Bright Chocolate Glaze.
This product was by far the biggest positive surprise in this test, because it is named and sold as a glaze, but in fact is an all-in-one polish type of product. And being such a product, it was clear that it would fare rather well in the departments of color enrichment as well as masking abilities. However, it also was extremely easy and pleasant to apply. It is very, very fairly priced at £14 for this 500 milliliters. And there is a big sale going on at Auto Bright every year. But all of this did not mean that it disappointed in the hydrophobic speeding and resistance department. And that really was the big surprise, because for such an all-in-one type product, this performed extremely well. And if all of that is not enough, it also comes with the best scent of all the products, because who doesn't like chocolate? It is not a liquid wax, so it is not included in the final ranking, but with 65 points, it did a very respectable result. This is a top candidate for the win of a future glaze test we will do. And after having worked with this, I really look forward to trying the actual liquid wax by Auto Bright, the Carbonuba. And for all those reasons, this product also gets a special price, and this is that it is our tip for quick and dirty jobs. Meaning that if you don't have the money, time, knowledge, skills, or tools to do a full paint correction job, and for all of you guys who offer non-correctional polishing jobs, this is an excellent product.
We already reached the top 5 of the liquid waxes, and with 66.25 points, the Yum Wax reached a very, very respectable 5th place and a fantastic result.
The Yum Wax also was a very pleasant surprise in this test, because to be honest with you, I tried quite a few products by Yum in the last couple of weeks, and for example with their ceramic detailer, their foam, and especially with their shampoo, my conclusion always was that their products work. They are average or slightly above average, but considering this performance, the price point of those products was rather high compared to what everyone else in the market is offering. The YumWorks is not a cheap product neither, but it's not ridiculously expensive. I would say it's bang in the middle where a lot of other liquid waxes are. And more importantly, it backs up the price with the performance that we saw in this test. It was one of the easiest to apply. It was one of the waxes which did the most for the finish in terms of a darkening or shedding effect, in terms of its masking abilities of light paint defects, in terms of the slickness that it created, and it did all of this in combination with a very, very pleasant fruity smell. All of this led me to giving this product the special price of the best show wax in this comparison. However, and contrary to expectations, this did not mean that this product did extremely bad in the hydrophobics, the beading, or the resistance department. Because normally, if you work with show waxes, they tend to be very poor in resistance and hydrophobics. And no, the YumWax does not create the tightest, the tallest, the roundest of beads, especially compared to something like Infinity Wax or Simple Wax. But the beading is there, the beading is good enough, and it is especially capable of upholding this initial hydrophobics for a very long time. And all of this means that with 66.25 points, it reached a very, very good fifth place in our comparison. And I also have to say, if the hydrophobics would have been a tiny bit more pronounced and the resistance would have been a tiny bit better, then this product would actually have the potential to have won this test. The only real gripe I have with this product, and this goes out to you, Yum, is that you recommend to apply it over the ceramic spray sealant that you offer. And this, in my personal opinion, does not really make sense. Yes, it makes sense from a finish perspective. However, because this product has a worse beading and worse hydrophobics than the ceramic has, I don't really see the point why you should apply this one on top of the ceramic. I think the other way around would make a bit more sense. However, then of course the ceramic cannot bond to the paint. It will just some sort of stick to the wax, but that's always the limitations of topping and layering. With 66.5 points, the next product technically is a liquid wax. However, it's still in development, and this is the mystery product by the unknown German manufacturer. Now, this product actually is a liquid wax. However, it is not included in the final ranking because it is a test, a development product, and is not finished yet. And you see this, for example, in the points table by the fact that it did not score any points in regards to the price as well as the scent, because we don't know those things yet. However, considering that it reached 0 points in two categories, the result of 66.5 points is very, very impressive actually. And it is also by far the best product out of Germany in this test. Even if there is strong competition from products which were not included in this test, for example, by Dr. Wack or by Zonex. So once again, looking at the points table, if this product will be reasonably priced, then it would actually be able to win this test or run with the very best products within this comparison. So it will be interesting to see how much this will cost when it finally comes out. But for now, it was one of the best liquid waxes in this comparison. It was the best German liquid wax, and it was the second best German product overall.
The next product reached 68 points, and therefore almost the top level of this comparison. And this is the paint sealant Soft 99 Fusocoat F7.
Once again, this is not a liquid wax, but a paint sealant, a PTFE or Teflon paint sealant to be exact. And so it is not included in the final ranking, but with 68 points, it did fare extremely well. And this once again shows that it did make a lot of sense for me to include such products as well in this test, because yes, the application is a tiny bit more complicated and you have to concentrate more if you apply those products, but it is not rocket science. And if you have a bit of experience in car care, you will definitely be able to do that. But this tiny bit more complicated application leads to this product being superior to many of the other liquid waxes we saw in this test when it comes to beading, hydrophobics in general, and especially resistance. And in this respect, I already know that there will be people amongst you who tell me I should not have included this one in the test because it is a fucking paint sealant and it is not a liquid wax. And to those people, I have to say, no one out there cares about your categorization of products. Because at the end of the day, the application is pretty much exactly the same with paint sealants as with liquid waxes. And the application is actually what counts for 99% of people out there. So stop thinking in categories of ingredients of those products, because it is old thinking and it doesn't help the car care industry in any way, shape or form.
The next product reached a fantastic 68.75 points, but is also not included in the liquid wax comparison because technically it's a paint sealant, and this one is the Polish Angel Master Sealant.
The Master Sealant by Polish Angel only was 0.25 points better than the Fuzurcoat F7. And this once again shows the limitations of points and ranking systems. Because 0.25 points does not sound like much, but for me personally, this is by far the better paint sealant than the Fuzurcoat F7. And this is mainly down to its incredibly easy application, which in my view does not differ in any way, shape or form to the application of any of the other actual liquid wax. However, once again, based on the ingredients, this is a paint sealant, and so it did not make it into the final ranking of those liquid waxes. As you can see by the points that it scored, it could have easily been one of the winners of this test if it would not be so incredibly expensive. No, it's nowhere near as expensive as the other product by Polish Angel, which we also had in this test, but it still is one of the most expensive products in this test. But despite that, I personally think that this is an excellent paint sealant, mainly because it's so incredibly easy to use. And this is why I personally will continue to use this also in the future.
We have now reached the products which performed significantly better than the others and reached way beyond 70 points. But once again, between the places 4-1, there are only 2 points of a difference. And therefore, it is very, very close, but on a very respectable, very deserved 4th place with 74 points is the Wowos Hot Wax.
As I said, we now have come to the products which reached above 70 points and based on my point system clearly were the best products in this comparison. And as you can see by the points table for the Wowos Hot Wax, this one does not really have any weaknesses and consistently scored a lot of points in every single one of the performance categories. And this is why I am naming this product the best all-rounder, because that is the very definition of a great all-rounder. It is good in pretty much any performance category, but does not have to be the best in all of those categories. All in all, it's a very good, a very capable, a very easy to apply product that also offers great performance in the hydrophobics, in the beading and the resistance department. Even if we saw that the beading is a tiny bit more pronounced than the sheeting, meaning if there is a lot of water, then this product starts to struggle compared to the very best ones. Also, I personally feel that it is a tiny bit too liquid, which is why it tends to sink into the applicator, whereas the products with a more thick consistency stay on the applicator. But this does not change the fact that it is one of the easiest products in this comparison to spread, which is why it scored 10 points in the application.
One important aspect regarding the Wowos Hot Wax I want to mention, because this probably is the reason why it is called Hot Wax. Wowos claims on the label that you can apply the product in direct sunlight and on hot panels. And this is actually the only product for which the manufacturer claims this. It is one additional reason why I declared this the best all-rounder wax, and it is something I thought is important to mention.
The price is not so much an issue for you guys in the UK out there, because in the UK the prices for this product are rather consistent and Wowos also does a sale from time to time. But for us in Central Europe, the prices vary a little bit, and if this would have been a bit more expensive, then it would not have scored so many points in the price department, and then the difference to the 3rd place would have been a tiny bit higher, which is why the 4th place for this product is okay. But with 74 points, it still was able to achieve a fantastic result, and it definitely is one of the best liquid waxes out there right now.
The next product reached 74.5 points and will be a huge surprise for you English guys out there, because the manufacturer of it has a somewhat questionable reputation, but his product in this comparison did extremely well And I'm talking about the Easy Nardo.
Now, of course, the results of this test do not change anything about the customer service by Easy or that their marketing department is very, very aggressive. I mean, guys, seriously, daily newsletters. But from a pure performance view, this product did extremely well in this test. It reached 74.5 points, which is only 0.5 points more than the Wobo's Hot Wax, which could lead to the conclusion that they are rather similar products, but in fact, they actually feel rather different. This already starts with the consistency because the Easy product is way, way thicker, which I personally think is the better consistency for such a liquid wax. The scent of the two products is actually rather similar, but yeah, the Easy product smells much stronger. And the Nardo has one major advantage over the Wobo's Hot Wax, and this is the ability to fill up light paint defects. In this respect, it was by far one of the best products in this test. It scored a lot of points in this category, and this is one of the main reasons why it scored so high in this test. But it also was very good at the hydrophobics, the beading, and the resistance departments. So, all in all, you get a fantastic liquid wax with the Easy Nardo, and this accounts for the original price of £16 for this 500 milliliters. But if you get this for half the price, because Easy does a sale every 2 weeks, then I actually think that you cannot go wrong with this product as long as you actually get it when you order it. Hashtag customer service.
We already reached the second place in the liquid wax comparison, and with 75.25 points, this goes to the Infinity Wax Turbo 6.
So, second place in our liquid wax ranking is the Infinity Wax Turbo 6. And the simple fact of the matter is, if this product would cost less, then it would have easily won this test. Because at £15 for 250 milliliters, this one is pretty much double the price of the other products that we will talk about in a minute. If you are able to overlook the fact that this is a comparably expensive product, then I actually think it is excellent. It did show one of the single best beading effects in this test, with the roundest, with the tallest, with the highest beads out there. It is very easy to apply despite its strange and changing consistency. It smells fantastic of bananas. And let's not about forget the fact that this product does actually contain carnauba, even if Infinity Wax says it is a cream sealant on the bottle there. So strictly and very technically, if the ingredients of such a product are important for you, then yes, this is the winner of the liquid wax comparison, because the other product that actually won this test is a synthetic liquid wax. So once again, a tiny bit too expensive in comparison, but regarding all the other performance categories, this is a fantastic product that I highly recommend, and I especially think that it is way better than anything that Meguiar's or Surfaces or Liquid Elements or other very, very big brands offer you. And if you are based in the UK or Scotland, you can also support a local manufacturer by buying from Infinity Wax.
Now, I think most of you are smart enough to have realized that we have only 3 products left. These are the ones that performed the best in this comparison, even if the results are very, very close. But the first place amongst the liquid waxes within this comparison with 76.25 points goes to the Simple Wax Liquid Armor.
Warning, if you are someone who is very strict in thinking about categories based on the ingredients of products, then this is probably not a liquid wax according to your definition, because this is based on synthetic waxes. So much like a Finish Care 1000P, a Soft 99 Fusocoat, a Soft 99 Waterblock, or many other synthetic waxes out there. But I personally don't care at all about the ingredients, and if the manufacturer calls it a liquid wax, then it is a fucking liquid wax. And therefore, I declare this product the winner of the large liquid wax comparison that we did. Now, unlike many other products which scored very high in our ranking, this is not a perfect product, because I already told you that in the removal it can feel a bit grabby until you break down this initial first crust of wax. And it does not do that much for the finish of your car, and this is something rather usual with synthetic waxes or paint sealants. But in the performance categories that matter and that I personally weighted a lot, this product excelled. It is easy to use, it smells very pleasantly. Yeah, of lemons.
Despite the fact that it is not the best at creating a color enrichment, it still has masking abilities.
And regarding the hydrophobics and the beading, it definitely was one of the single best products in this whole test.
It also was a rather incomparably resistant product. And if that would not be enough already, the manufacturer also says that you can use it as a topper for their also very good synthetic paste wax, which is also called Armor.
And the best of all this, you get all of this product, all of this performance for just £15 for 500 milliliters. So it also was one of the cheapest products in this test.
And to be absolutely clear about it, if it would have fared a tiny bit better in the color enrichment department and the removal, then it would have won this test by a long shot.
So yes, in the end, it was rather close between this one and the Infinity Wax Turbo 6, but mainly because you get this one for such an attractive price, this one won our big liquid wax comparison. And because of the extremely fair price that Simple Wax asked for this product, I also declare this one of our value for money winners.
We now have only two products left, which battle for the win outside of the strict liquid wax list. And with 76.5 points, so only 0.25 points more than the Simple Wax, we have a product which by all means does feel exactly the same as all of those other products.
And therefore could be included in this list.
However, based on its ingredients, it is a paint sealant, and this is the Wax Planet Lock and Load.
The Wax Planet Lock and Load broke my heart because based on what it says on the label that it is a hybrid polymer wax coat and therefore based on its ingredients, I just couldn't include it in the final ranking of the liquid waxes.
But regarding its performance, it would have won this test if it would have been included in the final ranking.
Because, and this is the main aspect, regarding its application, this paint sealant is exactly the same as all the other liquid waxes, meaning that it is as simple, as quick, as effortless to use as all the other products. And therefore it is definitely different to something like a Soft 99 Fusocoat F7 or to something like a Sonax Polymer Net Shield, which means that this is probably one of the single easiest paint sealants out there.
Based on what is written on the bottle there, I probably could go ahead and call this a liquid hybrid wax as much as the Collinite 476S is, for example. But for now, I did not include this in the liquid wax comparison and also the liquid wax ranking. I probably could have, it would have been okay, but nonetheless, the results are excellent and fantastic, and the fact that it is not included in the ranking does not change that in any way, shape, or form.
The only weakness that this product has is its scent, because yes, there is a scent there, but it's hard to put your finger on it, and it's not a very pleasant scent. It's more like a chemical smell. Not solventy, so I would not say that it stinks, but it just isn't up there with, for example, the Yum Wax, the Infinity Wax, or the Maracana by Wax Planet. And so at the end of the day, as I just said, it broke my heart because I could have declared this one the winner simply based on the point system that I developed. But because I know how strict some of you guys out there think in categories, I just couldn't say that this is a liquid wax, but I definitely wanted to tell you about its performance because once again, you get a very, very well functioning product, very hydrophobic, very resistant, still easy to use. And therefore, I will definitely do a single video of this one in the future because this is well deserved and an excellent product, even if it didn't make it into the list of our liquid wax comparison.
So this one is no surprise. We have only one product left, and this is the Sonax Polymer Net Shield. And strictly based on points, with 82.25 points, this one did actually the best in this comparison.
No, the Sonax Polymer Net Shield is not a liquid wax. It is definitely a traditional paint sealant type of product. However, I included this product in this test in order to show you the limitations of the category of traditional liquid waxes. And we absolutely and clearly saw that this product, regarding the color enhancement, regarding its masking abilities, regarding the slickness, and mainly regarding the hydrophobics, the beading, and the resistance, was by far the best product in this test. And that's the reason why it was the only product that scored more than 80 points in total. It is not a perfect product. It does stink. It is not the cheapest. And you definitely have to concentrate more when you apply it, especially during the removal, because the fact that it does create such a strong effect in the color enhancement, you have to be careful in order to not leave streaks or clouding behind. But with these words, we now go into the overall conclusion of this test, in which I will tell you a tiny bit more about the reason why it does make sense to include such products in such a test. So we are at the end of this big liquid wax comparison that we did. And now for the final conclusion, I want to talk about three important aspects. The first one is the reason why I included paint sealants in this liquid wax comparison. Because we clearly saw that there are paint sealants out there which perform significantly better than most of those liquid waxes, but are almost as easy to pretty much identical in the application. I'm looking especially at the Wax Planet Lock and Load now. But on the other hand, we also saw that there are very well functioning liquid waxes out there which can outperform paint sealants. And this is why such a test, which would only have considered true traditional liquid waxes, for example, based on the fact that they have to contain Canuba wax, would not have been a complete test in my opinion. And in this respect, my tip to every one of you out there, stop thinking in categories based on the ingredients of those products. Because such a very strict thinking in categories, in my personal opinion, is out of date and is old school. Most of the times it is only used to excuse a bad product performance. No one really cares about it. And the only thing that really counts is how those products are applied. Because we always have the same discussions when it comes to quick detailer spray waxes or spray sealants. At the end of the day, if you are standing in front of a shelf, then you see bottles with a spray trigger on it. And that's the only thing you really care about. You want a product that is simple, easy, and quick to use based on the fact that it is sprayable. And it's exactly the same story with those. It does not matter in any way, shape, or form what's in these products. What matters is how they are applied. And all of them are applied the same way. You put a tiny bit of product onto an applicator pad and then you spread it on the panel either by hand or by machine, and then you remove them with a microfiber towel. And all of those products work in the exact same way. And this is the reason why I included paint sealants in this test, and why I personally think that thinking in categories based on the ingredients of those products does not help us, you as consumers, or the car care industry as a whole help in any way, shape, or form. The second aspect is that regarding point system and rankings, there's always a subjective aspect to it. Because giving points to those products is already difficult. Do you give now 5, 6, or 7 points if you see that there is a darkening effect? And especially if you start to weight the categories of product characteristics in a different manner, then you can influence the results. What you cannot do is make bad products win such tests, but you can make those products look a tiny bit better than they actually are. And one critical note to myself regarding my point system, what I did not consider in the prices of those products and therefore in the value for money department, are costs for delivery or for customs. Because if you have to buy such a product abroad, then you of course have to deal with high delivery costs, but including them in my overall calculation would have been very, very tiresome and complicated, and that's why I only considered the RRP prices on the home pages of the respective manufacturers. And the third aspect we clearly saw is that there is no best product out there, because not a single one of those products scored 100 points, which would have been the maximum. But we clearly saw that there are differences. We saw that there are paint sealants out there which work absolutely fantastic. We have 5 clear winners in the category of traditional liquid waxes,
devices, which is the Simple Wax Liquid Armor, the Infinity Wax Turbo 6, the Easy Nardo, the Wobos Hot Wax, as well as the Yum Wax. Then we have a huge midfield of waxes which work well, but have some weaknesses in some areas. And then we also had waxes in this comparison, which disappointed in regards to their extremely high prices, their bad performance, or that they couldn't live up to the hype surrounding them. One of the most interesting observations for me in this comparison was that such a huge manufacturer as Meguiar's, who can spend so many millions of dollars into research and development, is not able to come up with a product that is clearly better than any of those other ones, especially when it comes to products from very small manufacturers, which sometimes are run by only one person. And in this respect, I want to ask you to help us in spreading the results of this video, because the very reason we make such comparison tests is to give small and local manufacturers the attention that they deserve, because they simply cannot spend as much money on marketing as, for example, as Meguiar's can do. And I personally think that people out there need to know that there are better alternatives to the Meguiar's Hybrid Ceramic Liquid Wax, which got a lot of attention last year. So let's work together and help those small and local manufacturers in getting a bit more traction. And this is it for this video. I am already looking forward to the second part, in which I test even more liquid waxes. For now, I want to thank you for sticking with us. If you like the video, leave us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.